Conniland is a weird amusement park located in Switzerland. Most coaster enthusiasts know this park exclusively for Cobra, the Bizarre Pax shuttle coaster. But that's just the beginning. This park has several other one-of-a-kind attractions, but is it ultimately worth visiting? Find out in this review of Conniland. Switzerland is home to two of the best roller coaster manufacturers in the world, in Bolliger & Mabillard and Intamin. Yet none of their roller coasters can be found in their native land. Even stranger, Switzerland in general is not a particularly strong country for amusement parks. Conniland is the largest theme park in the country, yet it only has one adult roller coaster, and it doesn't even boast 24 rides. But what it lacks in quantity, it makes up for in eccentricity. Conniland opened in 1983. This Swiss park takes up a super thin plot of land. This causes rides to be packed in really tight. Add in the fact that the park's two signature attractions, Cobra and Mammoth Tree, both run the length of the park, and you have a lot of kinetic energy as you walk down the small midway. I went in expecting this park to feel more like a carnival, but the park looked much better than expected. There were plenty of trees and plants around the park, filling in any gaps. Then many rides were lightly themed as well. There was no synergy between the theming of each ride, but they usually have a decorative structure or two. Take the Temple Station for Cobra, for instance, the ornate entrance for the Dino Attack Dark Ride, and the detailed backdrop for the Cobra Lino Kitty Coaster, just to name a few. The arrival experience for Conniland was a bit different than expected. Usually, I like to purchase admission in advance online, but there was no such option for this park. And that may be tied to this next part. Conniland did not seem to accept credit cards, so make sure you bring plenty of cash. As of 2021, daily admission for adults costs 31 Swiss franc. You have the option of paying Swiss franc or euros if you use bills at the ticket booth. All change is dispensed in francs regardless of which currency you use. And that's probably a good thing because the parking machine only accepts the native Swiss currency. I didn't buy any meals or souvenirs at Conniland, so I'm not sure which currency or currencies were accepted once inside the gate. I visited on a summer weekday and crowds were minimal. Almost every ride was a one cycle wait, with the exception of three. Then the two water rides had a 15 to 20 minute wait due to the warm weather, and then Mammoth Tree had a half hour wait all afternoon. This crazy sky ride is nearly 4 to 5 minutes in length and operates with just a single 16 person gondola. If you arrive at park opening, this should be your first stop. However, this likely is not a park you'll need a full day at. A half day was sufficient for me. And if you're a coaster enthusiast visiting exclusively for Cobra, there are two things you definitely need to watch out for. One, Cobra cannot operate in the rain. I suspect that may be related to the exposed brake and the scorpion tail element. Two, Cobra would not open with the park in 2021. On Cobra's page on the website, it was noted that the coaster would not open until the afternoon. This statement is now removed from Cobra's ride page, so I'm not sure if this will be continued going forwards or if it was just a temporary measure for 2021. Additionally, Cobra would go down frequently for quick checks. I believe the ride operator doubled as a mechanic because he would go beneath the track every few trains for 5 to 10 minutes. Others have seen this too, so maybe it's just the standard operating procedure, or maybe it could be related to maintenance because the coaster opened late every single day in 2021. Cobra is the main reason I visited Conniland, and it did not disappoint. This PAX creation is one of the world's best shuttle coasters. The trains feature both forwards and backwards seats, but that is just the beginning. The ride starts with this terrifying beyond vertical lift hill. Between the jerky process how the catch car engages the train and the super steep angle, it is terrifying. The resultant drop is incredible. It offers floater airtime with a fantastic free-falling sensation. It reminded me of the drops on the giant inverted boomerangs on steroids. The bunny hills that follow are tamer than I expected, but the super circular loop pulls some crazy G's going forwards. The spike in the far end is the one-of-a-kind scorpion tail, which offers crazy hang time as you come mere feet from the edge of the track, thanks to a brake. You then repeat the course in reverse. You have very little speed, so the vertical loop offers some great hang time in reverse, but the rest of the ride is a bore. The ride has some shuffling at points, but I found it tolerable. I go into more detail in a separate review, but the two spikes and vertical loop are fantastic. The only other coaster is Cobra Lino, a Gerstlauer kiddie racer that is exclusive to young kids. I don't even think an adult could fit in the vehicle even if they tried, so don't, because it's against park rules anyway. There are a few other kiddie rides towards the center of the park, plus some play areas. One of these play areas is outdoors, and another one is indoors. And then there's also a high ropes course suitable for all ages. The park has a very limited collection of adult flat rides. I counted 3 in total. There was a set of bumper cars, a swinging ship, and an S&S space shot. The latter is the park's tallest attraction. There was zero warning for the launch, and some faint airtime at the top. Plus, it was the best way to get an overall view of the park. I was stunned this park didn't have a single spinning flat ride though. Those seem to be staples at most other parks. For dark rides, there are 2. The straightforward one is Dino Attack. This ride had a fancy queue line and facade, but a very odd ride system. This Amperla attraction puts guests in cramped 4-person Jeeps, but only the front 2 riders are given guns. The guns had laser sights and there were plenty of targets to hit, most of which worked. There were a handful of dinosaurs too. None reacted to shots, but there were some adjacent to TV screens that activated a brief cut screen. Dino Attack is a decent shooting dark ride, and probably one of the best 3 rides in the park. The weird dark ride is Mammoth Tree. At first, this may appear to be an ordinary sky ride, but the gondola and cable wildly bounce up and down throughout the ride. Then there is this extended show scene inside a giant tree. I don't want to spoil what happens in there, but if you want to know, check out my separate review. This is a ride unlike any other, and it had me laughing start to finish. The park has 2 water rides. One is a small log flume called Wild Wasserbahn. The other is Voodoo Island, a hybrid splash battle and river rapids ride. And this is a rapids ride with a drop no less. I've never seen this ride system elsewhere, but the marriage of these 2 rides made perfect sense. The final notable attraction is a sea lion show. I skipped this show due to time, and I was able to see the animals in their habitat afterwards. So do I recommend Connieland? The park, while small, has something for everyone. Cobra and Mammoth Tree are 2 funky and highly enjoyable rides you cannot get elsewhere, but the lack of depth at this park makes it less of a priority compared to other European theme parks. Connieland may be the best park in all of Switzerland, but you do have better parks in the adjacent countries. However, Connieland can make for an enjoyable half day if you're in the area. And if you're a coaster enthusiast, Cobra alone is worth the pit stop once you hit the other major parks nearby, because you cannot ride anything like it elsewhere in the world. So those are my thoughts on Connieland, Switzerland's largest amusement park. What are your thoughts on this quirky park? Do you hope to visit it someday? I would love to hear your thoughts on the park or any of the rides down in the comments. If you enjoyed this review, I'd appreciate it if you gave this video a like and you considered subscribing, because there'll be a lot more roller coaster and amusement park videos here at Canopy Coaster. Thanks for watching.